if you should know what is the content in the bag, or if you should know what is the effect, or you should make a guess of what is in the bag, try to make a guess now.
Light.
You see a light, but can you see the light?
No.
Can you experience the benefit of the light?
Yeah.
No. What should I do if you should experience the benefit of this light?
Take away the cover.
Take away the cover. Do you agree? Yes. So a simple logic, a simple thing that we would say to the kids. Here we are, we have taken away the cover and there we have light now. Okay? We turn on the lights in the church now. A simple analogy, a simple factor for us to understand, a simple common knowledge. And children normally answer when we ask this question, what's blocking you from seeing the light? Of course the bag, so take away the bag. Now when we come to the truth and understand that this same light has been given to each and every one of us who are here right now, at the time of our baptism, we were filled and given all the gifts, all the graces that we need in life, and we were blessed abundantly. And we were shining like the angels in heaven. It is said sometimes in stories that when you go to heaven, and as you stand at the heaven's doors, the sign of the cross that was made upon your forehead at the time of baptism, the anointing that was given to you, will be shining depending on the life you have lived. And sometimes when I reflect, and when we go to retreats, and when we start evaluating our life and trying to find, sometimes in our retreats we are asked to write down all the sins that we have lived and we have done in our lives. And when we write down the sins, we can see that one or two foolscap papers are not actually enough. It's many, many sins that we commit in a lifetime. And to know that each and every one of these sins actually caused a kind of a shade, a covering up of this life of grace, of holiness, that we were gifted at baptism, at the time of the Holy Communion, and renewed. Actually, God gives grace through each baptism, through each sacrament, making us brighter and brighter, holier and holier, and leading us to that perfection which Jesus calls us and says, be perfect as my Heavenly Father is perfect. Now, through each sacrament that we receive, we are making a journey in holiness to be as perfect, as holy, as lovable as God Himself is. Now, what happens in the course of life? God knows that we are human beings, so we have our failures, we have our shortcomings, and we have our clumsiness, especially in the area of our sins. We fall again and again. And many times we have people who come to confessions, and some of them who do not come to confession precisely because they say, Father, I keep repeating the same sins again and again. So why should I go to confession? I would like to stop it for good and then go to confession. But that is precisely because they do not know the meaning of the grace in confession. Because when you go to confession, you're not going to confession because you are perfect right now, but it is because you know you are imperfect and you cannot overcome this sin again and again and again. And in the sacrament of confession, God gives you, as He takes away and empties your sins, He gives you the grace that you need to face this challenge in life. So the sin that we keep on falling in, we are empowered through these sacraments to actually challenge them, to go back, to counter them, and to seek our holiness in life. So actually, it is a beautiful, graceful, and uplifting experience of going through each sacrament. Now today, when Jesus calls us to be the light of the world, and to be the salt of the earth, it is precisely a bit of a mission. Now we know when we have light, or when we light a candle, we don't put it somewhere under an object. You do not hide it. Where do you normally tend to put the light? On the top, or on a space where it is high enough to be like a beacon of light to reach out to as much as area as possible. People who travel by ship would know of how important it is to have the light. What do you call that light? What's his nature? His nature is advised to be placed in a position that is the highest.
The highest, yeah.
So that if the beacon of that light will be so powerful as to reach into as much distance as possible, so that probably those who are lost, who cannot find land, by the help of this lighthouse, can find their way home safely. Brothers and sisters, each and every one of us are actually called to be a lighthouse, a power source of light that is shown upon a land and an earth of darkness. As we heard in the responsorial psalm, the just will be a light in darkness. Those of us who live and choose to live and try to live a life of holiness, a life that is as per the will of God, we will become in turn sharers of that light which Jesus himself is. Every time we have the Easter candle, which symbolizes Jesus, the Alpha and the Omega, and Jesus himself who said, I am the light of the world. He presents himself as the light of the world and asks us, every one of us, to be the sharers of that light so that wherever we may go, we will spread that light to people. We will spread that hope, that peace, that joy, that love to everyone we will meet. Now take the case of salt. We know most of our food, at least 90% of our food, we would like to taste it with an essence of salt. The very nature of salt itself is to bring out the taste that is there in the ingredients in the food that you have before you. So it brings out all the beautiful taste, the flavoring taste that you have in the food. It even has a healing power. When you have wounds, you apply the salt to your wound. It might stink a little, but later on, it heals faster. It heals both inwardly and outwardly. Its very color, whiteness, reminds us of how purity is all about. Its nature of blending in into whatever substance you add it to, it dilutes itself into the objects around it, again calling us to have the same characteristics as that of salt. So what are we called to do? We are called to be the people of hope, the people of love, the people who will give great taste to bring out the goodness in the people around us. So we are actually chosen to be, like Christ himself, chosen, called by God to be the source of blessing. Now we be blessing not by giving blessing to people, but we become a blessing to others when by our words and our actions we allow the person who is before us to become a better person. So it's not always about giving. It's not always that you have to give something. And that's the fear we have. Many times when the priests in the church ask, we would like to have more volunteers, we would like to have more help in this church, then St. Anne's happens to be the most active parish, or the largest, liveliest church in Denmark, with a large number of people turning up to Mass. So we have at least 1500 to 1600 people every weekend here in church. Now the question is, could we ask ourselves, how can I be a blessing to the other? How can I be a blessing to the other, not by just doing or giving, but by being a living witness, so that when others see me, they would like to say, that person is striving to do something good. Why can't I do the same? So that inspires someone else to come forward and to bring forward that beautiful light, that wonderful taste. I believe today we are all called to do the same, just as Christ himself was a light to the world, that we too may be a source of light. Today we'll try and sing a song and try to make it a prayer. Most of us know the song, so just let's try singing it and let's try praying it. Let's ask God to teach us how we can become a source of light to those around us. How we can be a source of tastefulness, a source of hope, a source of joy, peace, and love.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna.
As we go back, let's have the joy, just as we have right now, this very second, that little joy that you have within your heart. Blow onto it. Let it grow. Give more energy into it. Give more joy into it. And as you go back home, you will be surprised to see that your simple act of good deeds, as we heard in the scripture today, let not your light be covered, but as you give and share the light, let the world see the good deeds that you have done and glorify the Heavenly Father. The one call, the one message, the one mission that Jesus has for us, that we may share the light that we have, and that through our sharing, the world may see the good deeds you do, and thereby glorify the Heavenly Father. So brothers and sisters, let's take this message to heart, and let's go forth, being the light, being the salt.